Mina, konbanwa, Jesus Freaking Gamer here. Happy Easter! Happy Easter to all of you guys. It's so weird, like, at the beginning of the day, this is typical of me. I don't know how many of you even know me. I don't even know how many people are going to watch this message, but I'm going to go for it. Anyway, yeah, I woke up this morning, and I didn't even know it was Easter. I'm not joking when I said that. I remember the first instant today when I recalled that it was actually Easter Sunday. I was like, okay, church, you know what, gotta go to church, and, you know, what time is it now, and what time am I gonna actually have to get ready to go to church? And it occurred to me today, wait a minute, this isn't a normal Sunday, something's different. I knew something was different, and so I thought about it. I didn't look it up online, just kind of thought for a minute or so, and I was like, wait a minute, this is Easter. This is a special Sunday. This is the Sunday when, very potentially and very possibly, there are going to be a whole lot of cars at church, and it's going to be really, really jam-packed and plugged in because a ton of people come to church on Easter. And actually, the service that I went to was not particularly packed. A little bit disappointed, honestly. Although, granted, the last service at my church generally there aren't a ton of people, whereas the prior two services, they're a lot fuller, like a whole freaking lot fuller. I just really thought all three services would be packed on Sunday. Not on Sunday, on the third service, this Sunday, Easter Sunday. Pastor even made a big deal about saying, hey, everyone, invite people to church this Easter. A lot of people will come if you go to church this Easter. Honestly, I was one of the ones that didn't invite anybody. I thought of a few names, thought of a few potential candidates, but since I didn't end up seeing any of those people, I didn't go out of my way to call them, I didn't go out of my way to find them. Maybe I should have. Maybe I should have done just that. So, maybe I'm the guilty party there. Maybe I did miss an opportunity. And it's here forever on YouTube for me to reflect on, or for you guys to point out in the comments down below if you so want. Today is definitely going to be covering the resurrection of Christ, which is, even that's interesting to me. I didn't consider this an Easter Sunday. I'm the kind of guy who doesn't celebrate holidays. So, and I mean not any holiday. I just don't care about them. I don't see anything special about one day over another. Every day you live is a day that you can be thankful for, that you can glorify God in, that you can enjoy to the fullest. You can get a good night's sleep and, you know, God willing, you'll hop into the next one. Days to me aren't made because someone somewhere said, hey, this day's special. It represents this. So recognize it. For me, a day is special based on the things that happen in the day. Some days are very noteworthy and very rememberable. That was good English right there. Some days are very memorable. There we go. No re in front of it. And those are the days that actually matter to me. Those are the days that I actually care about. Just because a day is named, that doesn't make me care. Although, if I were to choose a day that I would care about, it would actually be Easter. Easter is debatably mentioned in the book of Acts. It talks about, there's a certain verse in Acts. I didn't prepare this in advance for this message at all. But there's a certain passage in Acts that talks about a very specific Sunday, the Resurrection Day, something to that effect, and in several translations, it's translated as Easter. And Easter was, to the best of my knowledge, the very first holy day. Or that's where we, of course, get the term holiday. It was the first holy day that the church picked up, if I remember correctly. And for very obvious reasons, it's the day that our Lord rose from the dead. If there was to be any holy day or holiday, that would be it. New Year's, I don't really celebrate. I know what the holidays are, I just don't go out of my way to celebrate them. Even though I did spend today with my family, I went over to their home and ate some, oh my gosh, really, really good food. Ham, green beans, buns, pineapple upside down cake, and the pineapple was actually upside down at first. I was so happy to see it upside down in the pan. I don't know why. I've never seen that, and it made me very happy. So it was a good day. It was a very good day. And today was a bit memorable because it was the first time that I can actively remember celebrating Easter. Like back in the day, my current family, family members change as time goes on. There are a lot of details there, and right now I won't go into them. Maybe at some point in the future I'll go into those more personal details. There are some things I still like to keep offline if possible at this point. But back in the day, my family just didn't celebrate Easter. We celebrated Christmas, we celebrated Thanksgiving. We did, what was it, black eyed peas and stewed tomatoes for New Year's, and we stayed up to New Year's and watched like some major TV show on it, but it wasn't like, we didn't gather family or anything. That was Thanksgiving and Christmas. We didn't really do anything for Easter. We really didn't. And 4th of July, that was the day that we celebrated. We got out, and we did some grilling. If you hadn't picked up on it, today's going to be a rambly day. Usually I go into, you know, great depths. Well, maybe not the greatest of depths, but I really do take some time to put together these 30-minute messages, and I took time. I took a few hours to look into things. I thought about them, and when it came time to teach the message, it was just like, well, it just, nothing really seemed to click. Nothing really seemed to come together for me, so I was like, you know what? I'm going to shoot straight from the hip. I'm going to shoot off the cuff. I'm just going to talk about stuff. I'm just going to let thoughts flow. I can certainly talk for 30 minutes. That's very easy. I have no problem talking for half an hour. I have no problem just letting thoughts spew forth from my mouth for that length of time. Probably much longer, even if it is unorganized. So if you'll forgive my rambliness, I shall continue. And if you're not really there, I will definitely bring home the point at the end. But there are lots of things going through my mind. So I'm like, I'm just going to talk about all of these unrelated incidents. And forgive me if I sound a little bit weird or my words are a little bit, I don't know, slurred, or they're not coming very readily. A little, not feeling the best today. Still fighting that stupid cold I was fighting a few days ago. And today I was a little bit on the losing end. Things weren't the best. So took lots and lots of medicine to be ready for this 30-minute message. Feeling a little drowsy, feeling a little tired. So please forgive me if... I was like, it's going to be rambly, and I'm a little tired. I just set myself up for a really good message, didn't I, guys? It's going to be the best! It's going to be, woo! It's going to be good. I'm going to keep going. Regardless, I don't care. I'm interestingly enough, despite the fact that I put time into putting this message together, and didn't really come together the way I thought it would, and despite the fact that I'm feeling a little under the weather, I'm a little bit excited to be talking about this message. And not just because I got to spend time with my family today, and that made today memorable because it was the first Easter that I've really celebrated. If I did celebrate one in the past, I don't remember it. So that made today a bit memorable, amongst other things that happened. They were very good things. They were just, again, on the personal side, so I'm going to keep them a little on the down low. Please forgive me if that offends you. I'm not trying to remain totally super secretive or anything. I'm open about a lot of stuff on this channel. There are just a few details here and there that I'd rather not get into. But thankfully, those were good details today. That was some good stuff. So yeah, Easter. It's just like, if there was a holiday I was going to celebrate, this would be the one, because it's the day my Lord rose from the dead. If I was to celebrate any single holiday, if there was ever a day to be special to me, this would be the day. And I think before the church started incorporating holy day after holy day after holy day, not just like Easter and then there was Christmas, I mean like on the, I'm referring specifically to the Catholic Church because they incorporated a lot of holy days into their calendar. I want to say that technically you could celebrate a different saint or a different tradition or a different something every single day of the year if you really stuck to the calendar. Christmas and Easter are the two big ones, but Easter predates the church being Catholic. Easter predates the time when Constantine basically said Christianity is the official government of the Roman Empire, and now, you know, pastors are also going to be governors, and then the church and the state just kind of melded into one. A lot of bad stuff happened after that. A lot of stuff I'm not personally very fond of. But Easter was there at the very beginning. And quite frankly, as well, it should be. Again, if you're going to have any kind of annual celebration, remembering the resurrection of the Lord, that's a good thing to remember. That is a worthy celebration. And the sermon today was so good. I don't know, how many of you guys went to church today? Would you leave a comment down below telling me whether you did or not? Whether it was good or not? I really enjoyed my message. I went to the church, and the pastor, he talked about... It's weird, because at my church, and I think this is more of a contemporary church thing, the pastor talks, generally speaking, about just... Instead of deep theological teaching issues, he leaves that more to like small groups. And he, during the Sunday message, he mainly focuses on very practical things, very down-to-earth things. He uses lots and lots of humor, very well, I might add, in the message to just kind of relate to people, give them something they can get through the week with, give them something to chew on, something that they can apply to their daily lives. It may not be the deepest thing. It may not be... It always has a biblical base, but it may not be like the most deeply theological, deeply biblical, deep, profound, true thing. It's just simple stuff like, you know, living your life to, you know, to better yourself, making plans and, you know, trying to be wise and trying to treat people kindly and forgiving your enemy and using very practical day-to-day examples and even using some of the people in the church and saying, by the way, this guy went through this and this is what God did to fix it. Just kind of neat little things like that. And today he really didn't deviate from that. He stuck along the same lines. He even had some guy that was recently saved, brought him up, and he shared his testimony with the church. It was a very powerful testimony. And not that this guy will ever see it. I didn't tell him that I had a YouTube channel. I don't know this guy personally. Didn't have a chance to meet him. If you ever do see it, dude, your testimony was fantastic. Easter Sunday at our church. I loved it. It was good. And it really set the tone for the message. It was good, good stuff. And so, yeah, the pastor, he related to people. He made the jokes, but he talked about the most important thing about the Christian faith that there is, and that's the cross and the resurrection. Palm Friday? That doesn't sound right. And if it is right, people are going to hate me. And that's not something that I didn't, even though I was saved in a more traditional church, we didn't go through any of the like old-timey holidays, any of the more traditional Christian holidays. We stuck with the big ones. Easter and Christmas, we didn't even celebrate. And actually, that church celebrated a lot of the American holidays, like New Year's and 4th of July. They might have even done some on Memorial Day and Labor Day. A very, very Americanized church. Now, that's necessarily a bad thing, although that's not necessarily a good thing either. But yeah, just celebrated the American holidays. Once again, days that I just don't care about. But, so yeah, whatever the Friday is when Jesus was crucified. Good Friday. There we go. Is it Paul? Palm Sunday. Palm Sunday is the Sunday before Easter. There we go. I got it! Took me a while, but I got it! That's honestly embarrassing. I feel like I should know that. Even though I don't care about holidays, shouldn't I know the names of these parts of the Christian faith? Well, I'm not losing a whole lot if I don't know them. It's not really that important, quite frankly. Even if I didn't know the name Easter, as long as I know that Jesus rose from the dead, that's what's really important. And that's what my pastor homed in on. I was going to steal most of his message from my message today because it was so good. I told him, I'm going to rip you off if you ever see this, pastor. I don't know. I put together all the stuff. I went through a few hours of prep. I went through all the points that I wanted to cover. And in the end, it just, I don't know, it didn't feel right. Why would I choose a rambly mess over a fine, dedicated point? Maybe it's because I'm not feeling too great. Maybe it's because, you know, I took plenty of drugs to make sure I could get through this message, you know, with a clear nose and a clear throat and a clear mouth. But for some reason, this rambly message, it just feels right. This just feels like the right thing to do. So I'm just going for it. Hopefully, it'll be more personable to you guys. Maybe it'll make y'all feel a little bit closer to me. Maybe it'll just open up a little bit more of my heart to y'all and get you an idea of who I am. Get you an idea of just kind of like sometimes the thoughts that go through my head. And there's not many thoughts more precious to me than the resurrection of Christ. In my practical church, he talks about stuff just to help the day-to-day guy get through the day-to-day. And today he covered salvation, the cross, the resurrection, the fact that Jesus lived, died, and rose again, and how he did all of that for us. So it was very gospel-centered, and which is good. On Easter Sunday, if you're talking in a church, it sounds so bad to say you want to win the converts, get them in, get them on the roster. And that's not even my church's point. If it was, I wouldn't be going to the church. Our church wants to change lives. It wants to build people up. It wants to introduce them to the God who loves them and who died for them and who currently lives for them. The God who wants to know them, love them intimately, like he created them to do, and change their life and make everything better, and to give grace and peace and joy during the hard circumstances and during the bad times. The God that wants to be there with us through the good and the bad. And it was just a good old salvation message. Like, hey guys, all you people who came to the church today who don't normally come to church, you don't know Jesus, but you're like, hey, I should go to church because it's Easter. Guys, here's this Jesus that you guys need to know. Here's this Jesus I want to introduce you guys to. Here's the Jesus who lived, died, and then lived again, and still lives, and is waiting on you to come to him. It's so good. It's so good. I so enjoyed it. This is not going at all like my pastor's message. This is much more direct and much more focused. It was good. It was so solid and good. But it's so interesting because, like, I wanted to do this message, I wanted to do a full 30-minute message today, and I felt like it was really important. And then when I prepared for it, and I didn't ended up getting a bunch of information, it just didn't seem to come together quite right the way I wanted to. And so here I am rambling. But I wanted to get this message out today, because the resurrection of Jesus is so important. It's the critical point to Christianity. It's the critical point of my life. It's the critical point, really, to all of creation. Because if Jesus had come and lived and died, he would have been one more man. God in the flesh or not, he would have been one more man with one more story. Great story to tell. That would have been the end of it. But it's not the end of it. Because he wasn't just God coming down to his creation to die for his creation. He was God coming down to his creation to forgive his creation, to bring them newness of life, and to guarantee them eternal life and the eternal destruction of sin and death. If I can just read, and of course I can, it's my 30-minute rambling message. I can do as I please. So I'm going to read Luke 24, starting in verse 1. Now on the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they and certain other women with them came to the tomb bringing the spices which they had prepared. But they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. Then they went in and did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. And it happened as they were greatly perplexed about this. I mean, it's kind of weird. You go to a tomb where someone was buried, the body should still be there, especially when there's a Roman guard guarding the tomb to make sure no one disturbs it. That behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. Then as they were afraid and bowed their faces to the earth, they said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spoke to you when he was still in Galilee, saying, 'The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified and the third day rise again. And they remembered his words. And they returned from the tomb and told all these things to the 11 and to all the rest. It was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the other women with them who told these things to the apostles. And their words seemed to them like idle tales, and they did not believe them. But Peter arose and ran to the tomb, and stooping down, he saw the linen clothes lying by themselves. And he departed, marveling to himself at what had happened.
Excuse me, guys.
Excuse me very, very much. Like I said, a little bit on the tired side right now. Can I just say, speaking of things that matter a lot to me, the resurrection matters a whole lot to me. Like I said just a minute ago, Jesus would have just been another man. Even if he was God in the flesh, he would have just been another man. If he had just, you know, come, lived a great life, preached some good things, and then died. Even a miserable, horrible martyr's death. But the fact that he rose again sets him head and shoulders above every other figure in human history. There's no one else like that. Of course, he was God in the flesh. And being God in the flesh, he should have a story much greater than anyone else's. He should have a life more victorious than anyone else's. And he overcame the grave. He overcame the sting of death. And he promises the same to any and all who will follow him. And interestingly enough, I will take this part from your message, Pastor, if you ever see this. This part I will particularly take. Of all the people to first show himself to, it was the women. Now, nowadays, that wouldn't matter very much. Like, you know, as long as you show yourself to someone who's sane, and they can be a credible source and go to the paper for you, or maybe, you know, bust out their phone, take a few snapshots, maybe put you on Snapchat or Instagram, make a YouTube video, something to that effect. You know, there you go. You've got your witness. You've got someone who said, hey, I've seen this. Here it is. Here I am. But back in the day, and this comes from my pastor's mouth, and I've heard this before as well. So feel free to Google it. Look it up and, you know, verify what I say we because me and my pastor because I got it from him, verify what me and my pastor are saying. The word of women didn't mean anything back in the day. Women couldn't even testify in court back in ancient Israel. Their testimony wasn't credible. It wasn't reliable. And didn't count for anything. And so the first people our Jesus shows himself to is women. That's kind of, I don't know, it's kind of incredible because it's like, of all the first people to show yourself to, the first person, excuse me, that you want to show yourself to, like, wouldn't it be Peter or John, you know, those big apostles, the ones that, you know, were full of fire and faith and wanted to do all these great things? Or how about showing yourself to the Pharisees? Wouldn't that show them? Like, boom, here I am. What you gonna do? I've already overcome death. You can't kill me again. Kind of like a ghost, but with flesh and bone. No blood. The blood was poured out. But yeah, it's like, can't kill me now. Here I am. What you gonna do? Maybe appearing before Pilate, who, under pressure and in weakness, agreed to the crucifixion of Jesus under pressure from the crowd and under the Jewish leadership and the Pharisees. But he didn't really, honestly, he didn't want to. When you look at the scriptures, it's pretty obvious that Pilate was convinced Jesus was innocent. He didn't want to crucify him. And since he was forced, I say forced, it was still his choice, but because he was so strongly pressured, thus forced into crucifying Jesus, he even mockingly and trollingly put atop the cross, "Behold the King of the Jews." And that was the charge against him. Basically, a giant middle finger to all the Jews who were like, hey, get this guy crucified. And Pilate was like, okay, we'll crucify him, but, you know, forget you guys. You know, I don't like you guys at all. And so just a flipping of the bird, if you will. It's quite, I'll say, I have to chuckle a little bit when I think about that, because it's just like, wow, Pilate just, and they were mad. They were like, take that down. And Pilate's like, I've written what I've written. Suck on that. He didn't care. But he appeared to a group of women. Not any of those other people. They were the first ones that he showed himself to. The women who had been faithful in his ministry, who he had delivered. It says, I forget in which particular gospel it says it, but Mary Magdalene, who was there, she was one of the women. She had 7 demons cast out of her. She was this really just messed up person. She wasn't necessarily the woman caught in the adulterous act. That's a church tradition, referring to John chapter 8, verses 1 through 11. Excuse me again. That very, very popular story. He who is without sin, let him cast the first stone. That wasn't necessarily her. Again, that's just a church tradition. But she did have 7 demons that were cast out. That's in the Bible. That's not just church tradition. She had a messed up life. And she was one of the first ones that Jesus appeared to. He didn't appear to the influential, to the rich. He didn't appear to his enemies. Or the people who'd caved in to weakness but didn't really want to hurt him and were incredibly politically powerful. It would have loved to have spit that back in his enemies' faces. He didn't go even to the strong turned weak, Apostle Peter, who would eventually lead the church. He didn't go to any of them first. He went to the women who he had delivered out of many, many troubles. The people that he ministered to. The people he cared about. Well, he cares about everyone. He loves everyone. But the people he'd personally ministered to who had needed his help. The people that society didn't care about. That didn't think they were reliable, credible witnesses. Those are the first ones God paid attention to when he rose from the dead. If that fits you, that's who you are. Can I tell you that he hasn't changed? Yesterday, today, and forever, God is unchanging. Just as he was then, he is now. And to those who feel unimportant, to those who feel, let me close up the books of study here, to those who feel outcast, abandoned, let down, worthless, he did this for you. He died for you. Yeah, he died for everyone. He loves everyone. Absolutely. And there's nothing he doesn't know. There's no one he doesn't see. Nonetheless, you've got his attention right now. Right now, you've got his attention. Today, Resurrection Day was for you. He came to this world. He died on the cross, shedding his blood for your sins. And then just to one up all that man had messed up, he rose from the dead, showing that the grave, showing that death and its sting held no power over him. And he extends that power to you right now. If you will believe in his name, if you will repent, turn away from your sins. And a lot of you want to turn away from your sins. You actually want a way out. Good news. He came for you. You cast those 7 demons out of Mary, whatever it is that you've got in you, whatever addictions, whatever problems, maybe actual demons. I do believe those are still in the world today, and I believe they're literal and real, just like the Bible talks about. You've even got those in you. Jesus came for you. He died for you. To all of you out there, lonely, bedraggled, worthless, demon-possessed, Jesus came for you, and this day was for you. Although technically it's Monday now, just to continue on the rambly note, it's Monday, and Monday while I'm recording, and it'll be Monday before you guys see it, because it's going to take a little bit of time to get on YouTube. But won't you right now accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior? A lot of you want to. A lot of you want a way out of sin. You want a way out of this life that you've been living. You've been desperately longing and searching for a way, and here it is. You've watched this entire video. You've listened to me ramble for almost 30 minutes now. why don't you seal the deal? Why don't you come completely clean before the God who created you? Why don't you give in to His love, His grace, His mercy, all the forgiveness that you could ever want or need? It's right here. If you want it, just ask Him for it. Just say, Jesus, I want you. Jesus, I need you. Jesus, save me. Jesus, forgive me. Jesus, be my God, my Master, my Savior. And He'll do it, just as you ask. And if you want a model prayer to pray, feel free to pray this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I admit that I'm a sinner. I believe You died on the cross, shedding Your blood to forgive me of my sin. And I believe You rose again today, technically yesterday, to give me eternal life with You. And right now, I just accept You as my Lord and Savior, and I accept Your offer of eternal life. Thank You, Jesus. Amen. And guys, if you prayed that prayer, congratulations. You're saved. You're going to heaven. All those sins, all that baggage, all those bad things, even if man won't forgive you, even if there's a price to be paid for it, God's forgiven you. He loves you. You're a part of the family. And He'll be with you through whatever hard times you've got to face. It's a good day. It's a new day and a new time. And I'm thankful that I was the one who got to share this with you in my rambly, long-winded way. If I could encourage you before I go, and before you go, please read your Bible just a little bit each day to get to know this new God of yours, what He thinks, how He feels. Find a church that believes in the same God as you, that believes that the Bible is the Word of God. Find some believers who believe the same things as you, because it's greatly encouraging and rewarding to find people who feel and believe the same as you. And if you need help, because life begins here with Jesus. It doesn't end. It begins here. Doesn't mean you're not going to have a rough day. And if you do, pray. Just say, God, I need help. This sucks. God hears even a simple prayer like that. And a prayer, I will add, that some more conservative churches might consider a little blasphemous. And even if I'm wrong, and even if it is blasphemous, God knows the heart. And even if you have a sin that needs forgiven, He is able to forgive that sin. He's able to convict you of that sin. And He will give you that help that you need for the days that suck. Guys, thank you very much for giving me the time of day once again. Happy Easter. At this point, belated. I love you. And God bless.